वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल प्रोडक्ट। द सेंट्रल ड्रग स्टैंडर्ड कंट्रोल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट इज CDSCO, विच इज अ नेशनल ड्रग रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी, regulates the import and export of the drugs in the country through the port offices located at different parts of this country. So with the help of this port control, we can regulate import and export of drug in the country. So WHO GMP certificate is mandatory in most global markets for pharmaceutical companies to be able to sell medicines. This WHO and GMP certified products are accepted globally. The manufacture of an exporting countries must be licensed by the regulatory authority of that country and comply with the WHO GMP guidelines. The manufacturer of the particular product should comply the licensing authority or rules framed by this licensing authority along with WHO and GMP guideline. Then his or her product will be able to sell into worldwide. The certificate of pharmaceutical product, that is CPP or COPP, is issued in the format recommended by WHO. Means by issuing this certificate from WHO, manufacturer can certify his or her product and sell that product into this different country. And that certificate is known as certificate of pharmaceutical product. Now we'll see why it is important, why it is required to issue. It is needed by importing a country when product in a question is intended for registration, then license, that is licensing and authorization or renewal of registration with scope of commercialization or distribution in that country. If this certificate is there with manufacturer, then it will be easy to distribute your drug into the different countries. Certification has been recommended by WHO to help undersized drug regulatory authorities or drug regulatory authorities without proper quality assurance facilities in importing countries to assess the quality of pharmaceutical product as a prerequisite of registration or importation. And if certification of WHO is there, then your product is fulfilling prerequisites required for the import and registration of product into the different country. Now, who will issue this certificate? The application of grant of WHO GMP certificate of pharmaceutical product shall be made to respective zonal or sub-zonal officers as per the requirements. Then this COPP will be issued by zonal or sub-zonal officers on behalf of Drug Controller General after inspection and satisfactory clearance by CDSCO officer as per WHO and GMP guidelines. So the manufacturer is applying for the issuance of this certificate for particular product, then predetermined format is there of WHO. In that format, that manufacturer should give a proper information or fulfill that regulatory pro pharma and submit it to the WHO. Then the officers of this CDSCO evaluate that application by inspecting actual site of manufacturing, and if satisfactory clearance is there by this inspector, then this certificate is issued to that manufacturer. Now what they will look after in this plant or at a manufacturing site, whether there is a WHO or GMP guidelines are followed or not, whether each and everything in this manufacturing plant is as per the WHO and GMP guideline or not. Now we'll see general requirement for the submission of the application for issue of COPP. A forwarding letter or application shall be addressed to DDC1 or ADC1 of respective CDSCO, zonal or subzonal offices with copy of covering letter and product summary sheet to DCG1 by authorized person only. So manufacturer can apply to the zonal officer or subzonal officer along with the covering letter and summary of your product. Application should clearly indicate for fresh certification or reissue of product applying according to it will be scrutinized for the product applied. Application will be reviewed by CDSCO officers, and completed application in all respect would accepted for inspection on first come first basis. This number of applications are there, and these applications are reviewed by these CDSCO officers in a sequential manner, first come first serve basis. Then forwarding letter or application shall be accompanied with list of products applied for the grant of COPP. If manufacturer is having a number of products, then that manufacturer should give a list of that product for issue of this COPP. Along with product permission copy, then manufacturing license issued by the SLA and notarized product summary sheet, then site master file as per WHO and GMP requirement. Then list of major documents like master validation plan, then quality manual specification, master formula record maintained by firm, or list of SOPs are followed into the manufacturing plant, then layout of manufacturing plant, list of personnel working in this plant, what exactly their designation and qualification and experience, then list of equipments available into the plant, then instruments, then utilities along with make and model and capacity of that particular equipment or instrument. Then list of primary and secondary impurities and reference standard available with firm relevant to these applied product for granting purpose is required to submit along with this COPP application. Now we'll see procedure for this accepting application for issue of COPP. Application forwarded by before 1/10/2009 will be considered provided they should resubmit the application in revised format with forwarding letter. Then notarized product summary sheet and other document which were not submitted earlier as per requirement on first come first serve basis. All applications reviewed will be scrutinized by CDSCO officers after receipt, and query letter will be sent to the applicant if any or otherwise will be considered for the inspection. The inspection will be carried out by CDSCO officer as per WHO and GMP guideline of TRS 823 and 90 or 908 for non-sterile product. These are guidelines, a number of guidelines for particular product. For non-sterile it is TRS 823 902, then for sterile product it is 822 902, and for relevant guideline in TRS 937, TRS 929 and TRS 863 as applicable from time to time for different products. Self-appraisal checklist should be filled and submitted to CDSCO officer before inspection. Then inspector team verify that checklist at time of inspection. Means this officer before inspection gives one checklist, and as per this checklist manufacturer himself or herself fill that checklist, and during period of inspection that checklist is required to submit that inspector who is going to conduct this inspection, and that checklist is verified whether these type of the equipments are available or not. If manufacturer is saying these equipments are available, then that should be there. Inspector brief the inspection findings at a exit meeting, and report should clearly define deficiencies as per WHO and GMP guideline. After inspection, the CDSCO officer prepare one report, and that report clearly mention deficiencies present into the particular manufacturing plant as per WHO GMP guideline. Then respective zonal or sub-zonal certifying authority prepare a review report based on the review of observation and observation of checklist and written inspection report as per the GMP guideline. Then firm may reapply if required after proper compliance after 5 months from the date of rejection. Means if manufacturer rejected by this CDSCO officer after completion of 5 months, that manufacturer can reapply. If the same firm applies after 5 months, scrutiny of such application should be asked for earlier compliance with documentary evidence in addition to usual general requirement for submission of application for issue of COPP. Manufacturer should ask first for previous or scrutiny of previous inspection and its compliance along with this documentary evidence. So first of all, that scrutiny has to be solved and related document has to be submitted by this manufacturer to this CDSCO officer. Then he or she can submit documents of this reapplication. Then format of the COPP. This certificate confirm the format recommended by World Health Organization. Number of certificate, then exporting and certifying country, importing or requesting country, name and dosage form of product. In these sub points are there, that is API, amount of per unit dose, then is this product licensed to be placed on market for use in exporting this country, yes or no, is this product actually on market in exporting country. If answer to 1.2 is yes, continue with section 2A and omit section 2B. If answer 1.2 is no, then omit section 2A and continue with the 2B. Means depending upon answer of that manufacturer, next format will be considered. Either it is 2A or 2B. What exactly 2A, 1 format? Number of product license and date of issue. Then product license holder name and address. Status of product license holder. For categories B and C, the name and address of manufacturer. Producing dosage form is a summary basis for approval appended, yes or no. Then S is the attached officially approved product information, complete and consonant with license. Applicant for certificate, if different from license holder, then 2B section, it includes certificate of applicant, name, address, then status of manufacturer or applicant, then why is marketing authorization is lacking, not required or not requested, under consideration or refused. Then the remarks. Does the certifying authority arrange for periodic inspection for the manufacturing plant in which the dosage form is produced? Means whether periodic inspections are there in this manufacturing plant, then documentary evidence is required to give for these inspections. Then if inspection was not happened in that particular plant, then we can put it not applicable or no. Then if inspections are there before this reviewing by plant of the manufacturer by CDSCO officer, then documentary evidence is required to give that officer. If not or not applicable, proceed to question 4. Periodicity of routine inspection. Has manufacturer of these type of dosage form been inspected? Yes or no. Do the facilities and operations conform a GMP as recommended by WHO? Its facility and required for the manufacturing and operation of that particular product, and its facilities should comply with this GMP and as per the recommendation of WHO. Does information submitted by applicant satisfy the certifying authority on all aspects of manufacturer? On all aspects of the manufacture of product, yes or no. If no, then explain why it is no. Then details of telephone number, then fax number, then name of person and signature, along with the address of certifying authority, stamp and date. So this is format of COPP. This is a process flow of approval of your COPP application. The certifying recipient authority submit this application to the issuing authority, and then by after review of the CDSCO, your product gets certified with this COPP. These are documents required for the applying of the COPP or for the revalidation of COPP. First, document application from manufacturer, then site master file, copy of manufacturing license of that product, list of approved products, list of product applied for issuance of COPP. List of approved product means that products which are approved by the regulatory authority to manufacturer. Then list of products that has to be required issuance of COPP. Then along with this, that manufacturer also provide SOPs and STPs followed in the manufacturing plant. Then stability data for last three batches, accelerated or real time data for the stability is required. Then list of equipments and instrument, list of technical staff and the qualification, then experience and approval status along with the documentary evidence. Then manufacturing layout plan, process validation for three batches of each product. Means if you are applying for three products, then stability data of 9 batches is required for submission of COPP application. Schematic diagram of water system, specifying circulating loop, then material of construction, then schematic diagram for HVAC system, specifying terminal filters, configuration, then export data for last 2 years in case of revalidation. You see, your COPP certificate is issued by manufacturer in last 2 years, then it required to revalidate. And for this revalidation purpose, export data of last 2 years is required to submit by this manufacturer. So this is all about certificate of pharmaceutical products. Thank you.